Hello everyone. Let us move towards another problem under your comparative statement analysis, which helps us in doing the financial statement analysis. The problem given to us over here is, from the following information of BKC Limited, prepare a comparative statement for the year 2018-19. What is given to us over here is, by looking at the figures, we understand it is nothing but an income expenditure statement. We have gross sales minus returns, net sales minus cost of goods sold, gross profit, other expenses, total income goes on till net profit. So by looking at the particulars itself, we can make out that this is nothing but an income expenditure statement of BKC Limited. And we have got 2 years figures. The figures are there for 2018 and for 2019. By looking at the figures, what we understand is, see, the gross sales, we have 14,50,000 in 2018, and 19 it has gone to 16,30,000. Net sales were 14 lakhs, which has gone up to 16 lakhs. Gross profit was 2,10,000, now it is 3,70,000. Expenses were 71,400, it is 73,000 now. And total income 1,41,000 to 3,13,100. Net profit has went up from 1,33,500 to 3,09,220. So these are the figures that are available to us. By just grossly looking at the figures, we can still say that the figures have increased. But by how much have they increased? What impact has it got on the overall profitability? Which figure has increased by major proportion than the others? Cannot be just interpreted by looking at this figure at a glance. So what we need to do is, we need to frame the comparative financial statement. In the comparative financial statement, there are two things that we need. Yes, there are two things. One is your absolute change, and second is the percentage change. What is the absolute change? Absolute change is nothing. How do we calculate absolute change? It is nothing but the current year's value minus the previous year's value. Maybe the net profit. So current year's net profit minus previous year's net profit. Whatever difference we get from the 2 years figures will give you the absolute change value. And what is this percentage change value? It is nothing but the absolute change upon previous year's value multiplied by 100. What is it? It is nothing but the absolute change value upon previous year's value multiplied by 100. So whatever changes have occurred over here, this change upon the previous year's value would be multiplied by 100, and we would be getting the percentage change. Applying these, what we get is, see here, the particulars are the same as that given in the question. The figures for 2018 and for 2019 will remain the same as given in the question. What we have done is, the absolute change that comes into rupees, that is nothing but your current year's value, 16,30,000 minus 14,50,000, comes down to 1,80,000 rupees. Yes. Returns were 50,000, this year it were 30,000, so the difference is of 20,000 rupees. So net sales have gone up from 14 lakhs to 16 lakh rupees, meaning there is a change of 2 lakh rupees. Similarly, gross profit has gone up from 2,10,000 to 370, so there is a 1,60,000 difference. Total expenses have gone up by 1,600. Total income has gone up from 1,41,000 to 3,13,100. So that's by 1,72,100, and net profit has increased by 1,71,720. So these figures of absolute change tell us that whether there has been an increase or a decrease, like in some cases, and if there is an increase or a decrease, it also tells us by how much there has been a change. And this statement also goes ahead and gives us the percentage change values. How do we calculate this percentage change value? Is nothing but, say, this absolute change figure. Say, for example, 1,80,000 divided by the previous year's value. So it is 1,80,000 divided by 14,50,000 multiplied by 100. And what do we get is 12.41%. In case of net sales, there is a change of 2 lakh rupees. Compared with 14 lakhs, that's of the previous year's value, multiplied by 100, we get 14.28%. Similarly, the gross profit has changed by 76.19%, which is really great. Total income has gone up by 122%. See, 1,72,000 is the increase from 1,41,000. So that is more than 100%, 1,22,005%. And net profit from 1,11,500 has gone to 3,09,220. That is, the net change is of 1,71,720. That is 124%. Yes, now by looking at this statement, we can easily make out that which item has increased by a greater proportion and which item has decreased by a greater proportion, or which item has increased by a lesser proportion. So we can easily compare the 2 years' performance item wise, whether it is because of selling expenses or administrative expenses, or maybe operating income or other type of income, or is it the overall cost of goods sold, or what exactly has impacted your net profits. Yes, so that's the beauty and that's the utility of the comparative statement. That is why it is used for financial statement analysis. I hope you all have understood this. Yes, so go ahead and practice this in your notebook. Now, when we look at the interpretation part, what do we write? The company has tried to reduce its cost, and so as a result, the total profitability of the company has increased. What is this? This is the interpretation which we have already seen. Because the cost has gone down, because the expenses have reduced, and the overall operating income has gone up, the profitability of the company has gone up. This is nothing but the interpretation which we have inferred from the comparative financial statement. Yes, over here we complete this problem. So everybody, please practice this problem as much as you can. Thank you.